Lord, I want to be with you. So I really care about, I want to be with you. I really want to be with you. Jesus, I
Lord, you share.
sin on first. John 19, 34. He refuses. Because within that sponge was a mixture of mirth that would have been kind of medicated. It would have gave a numbing effect to the pain he was experiencing. So it would have kind of eased a little bit of the pain off. He refused it because he says, I will not medicate this morning. I'll take all the pain. Because I won't be with you. Surely you can go through whatever the pain you have just to be with you. Ain't it worth it? Lord, just be with you. Help us not forget what you went through, Lord, so we could be. Consider the cross, your faith will fail. You won't continue. People are stopping all the time because they're looking everywhere but the cross. Preachers are quitting preaching because they're looking everywhere but the cross. If you ever really get a glimpse of the cross of the Lord Jesus, won't only not quit, you won't even think about it no more. Well, because in Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 says, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him despised the shame and the spitting, and is set down at the right hand of God, his throne. This is Hebrews 12, 2 and 3. Listen, he said, considering him that endures such contradictions of sinners, lest you faint and be weary in your minds. Wow. Lest you faint, what? And be weary in your minds? Somebody said, considering him who endured, somebody shout, who went through the contradictions. That means those that contradicted him, those that came against him, those that crucified him. This is the message of his cross. He said, consider what I did on my cross and what I endured as I despised that shame. And he said, look at it. I counted it joy. It was set before me. And I counted it joy. Somebody shout, joy still in the cross. I'm telling you, that's where the joy of the Lord is. It's still at the cross tonight. And if you want to sustain your joy in the Lord, you got to make sure you revisit his cross. Look at your neighbor and say, if you want the joy of the Lord, you got to stay cross-eyed. Come on, somebody. You got to keep the cross in view. Hallelujah. Because if you don't, you begin to think you're the only one going through something. You'll think you're the only one. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Listen to the word of the Lord. Again in Hebrews 12:3, he said, consider him. So I say, consider the cross. Say that with me. Consider the cross. Consider him that endured these contradictions of sinful men, lest you be weary and faint in your mind. If you quit, you stop looking at the cross. If you walk away from God, if you throw in the towel, you have stopped visiting the cross. Because if you really get a vision of what he did for you while he was hanging on that Roman rugged to the cross, you wouldn't be so quick to quit. Amen. Somebody shout, the quitting would be quit, not you. The stopping would be stopping, not you. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Amen. He counted it joy. You know why he counted it joy? Because he looked from the cross to now and he saw me. He saw you. Come on, somebody. He saw somebody redeemed, washed in the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Following him. Hallelujah. With eternal life abiding in them. He looked beyond.
called that moment at the cross encountered joy. Somebody shout at the cross. That's where you can see beyond the battle. That's where you can see beyond the storm. That's where you can consider the circumstance further than you do in the present. Come on, somebody. In fact, this is the end, and it's over with right here. I'll never get out of this. Come on, somebody. At the cross, you can see further, hallelujah, than you can see at any other time. In the shadow of his cross, I can see it's joy. Come on, somebody. See joy coming in the morning. Hallelujah. Psalms 30, verses 5. Somebody shout at his cross. It's joy. And he said the joy was before him. Jesus not only saw the empty tomb 3 days later, but he saw me and you. He looked that far into the future. People that stop seeing their future in God stop visiting his cross. You better hang out at the cross. Come on, somebody, daily. Because if you really, amen, recognize, if you really remember him, that's why there's a remembrance table at the front of a lot of churches in the pulpit and altar in remembrance of me from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. It ain't just about communion. It's about discerning the body of the Lord. Come on, somebody. It's about discerning what he went through for you. I get so tired of hearing saints who are tired and look at me like I ain't tired, like I don't ever get tired. And all they ever talking about is quitting. You see them on Facebook every time they talk. They talk about, I just don't know if I'm going to go no more. I just don't know. Boo hoo, boo hoo. Them's the ones I purposely try to offend. Come on, somebody. Why? Because you got to offend them somewhere along the road to get them to get their eyes off themselves. Because all they're doing is sitting. If all I did is sit around and thought about me, come on, somebody, and talk about me, mine, and I, and in my problem, my struggle, my trouble, my hood. Somebody shout, that's the quickest you can get depressed and stay depressed. If all you do is sit around and think about yours. Somebody shout, stop considering yourself so much and consider what he did on the cross. Hey! Watch out. Consider the cross. Consider what he went through. And somebody shout, your face will get turned right side up again. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I'll never get a person telling me that statement years ago. He said, Brother Marvin, you just don't know what I've had to go through to follow Jesus. We're here to say goodbye to the dearly departed. They're dearly and they've departed. We wish them they would and won't have any praise God. But listen. Amen. I won't ever get that person telling me, Brother Marvin, you just don't know what I've had to do and go through to follow Jesus. And they were speaking this in light of just giving up. Almost like it's not worth it. And I said, boy, you ain't looked too far past the present, have you lately? I said, matter of fact, before you can ever look forward into the future, you got to look back in the past somewhere. All the way back about 2,000 years ago, back at the foot of his cross where he shed his blood. Because all I hear you talking about is what you went through to follow him. Have you stopped to look back and see what he went through so you could follow him? How dare you stand there and talk about quitting? How dare you stand there and talk about giving up? Give up? What's that? Quit? What's that stuff? I hear people say, hey, somebody chased me down to Walmart one time. Some church members pay their tithes. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise the Lord God. And said, Brother Marvin, I heard you stopped. I heard you quit. I said, do what? I said, man, that makes me mad. Quit, what's that? Stop. I said, 1 Corinthians 16 and 13, the Bible said, quit ye like men. Say that with me. Quit ye like men. Be strong. Now the word quit in Greek, it don't mean quit like our English word quit. Quit in English just mean quit. Look at the name, it said quit just mean quit in English. But in Greek, the word quit simply means be courageous. Paul said to the Corinthian church, quit like men. Somebody look at the name and say, real men don't quit. They're courageous. Come on, somebody. They don't turn around when times get hard and stuff gets tough. Come on, somebody, and put a tail between the legs. Still ain't figured out how a man would do that. But anyhow, come on, somebody, and run. They don't run away. They don't quit. Come on, anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Times get hard. They don't bother fixing up to God. They're talking about, well, I ain't going back to church no more. If you can backslide that easy, I'm afraid you never slid in to begin with. You can't get over Jesus just overnight. You can't get over him if you've been to his cross that easy. I've seen some people that get over him too quick. They get over him too easy. You know why? They never came to him to begin with. Never allowed me down to the altar and I joined the church. Good, did you come to Christ? Well, I ain't going back to church no more because Brother Bucky Math and sitting the same people here at my feet. Look at his neighbor say, if Christ is in your heart, Chip won't stay on your shoulder longer. Have you ever heard such? I'm quitting because somebody offended me. Last time I checked, somebody didn't hang on the cross for me. Someone did. Amen. Not somebody, someone. Amen. Jesus did. Last time I checked, over 25 years ago when I knelt down, I didn't cry out to a denomination. I didn't call out to a prince of preachers with shiny shoes, put on a three-piece suit and slick hair with a mega church. I didn't call on the name of a man. I didn't call on the name of an organization.
Serve
Jesus.
Yeah.
We still alive, Brianna? Hallelujah. My God. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, who you follow?
Well, I ain't going back to church no more because the preacher offended me. I ain't going back down there to church no more because they didn't pat me on the back.
You know why people get so offended anymore? Because somewhere in their heart and life, unseen to the natural eye, is a room that they still have reserved for their glory. That's why most people get offended. They get offended because it's something about them. Them not being noticed. Them not being used.
Me and mine. The trinity of being.
Come on, anybody here, Holy Ghost? When you're dead to you, I'm talking about all of you, and all you gathered together for is for His glory. Come on, somebody. All you care to do, man, is see His glory. Come on, somebody. You don't get offended that easy. The reason some people get so offended is because somewhere deep in their heart of pride, there's a room reserved for their own applause and their own glory. Come on. And those are the ones that won't come back to church if they don't get to play their guitar every time the church goes. If they ain't the one playing the piano every time, they ain't the one singing, won't play the drums. Been to get in the room right with somebody there in the living room if they ain't the one preaching. I know the preachers that won't go to church if they don't get to preach. Repent! Come on, somebody. They still get offended. Anytime it ain't about celebrating them. Hallelujah. Somebody shall consider the cross. Get you focused back on Him. Come on, somebody. Because if you don't, you'll faint. You'll get so weary in your mind, according to Hebrews 12 and 3. You'll turn back. You'll stop following Him. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And I tell you again, I see people all the time, I hear them all the time, talking about like they're contemplating quitting. I'm just going to quit serving God. I tell you what, I just can't do this no more. That is a person who has stopped looking at His cross. How in the world can you turn back from Him and turn His back to that Roman rugged cruel cross and lay all His life down so you can come into the presence of God here on earth, and when your earthly experience is over, step into eternity and live with Him forever? Come on, somebody. What in the world is anything more worthy than that? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Is time so tough? Come on, somebody. Is life got that hard? Praise God. That you want to return back to the yoke of bondage, back to the sin, back to the pleasures of this world. Just it's going to last for just a moment, because the pleasure of sin's only for a short season. Hebrews 11 and 25. Is it really? Is that the worthy cause that you want to return to and forsake? Come on, everlasting life for just that. Quit. What is that? Turning back? What is that? Look at your neighbor and say, it is possible to stop thinking about even turning back, much less turning back. Stop thinking. You really get a revelation of what He went through for you. Why in the world would you even want to go back? Come on. Help.
Brother Marvin, you just don't know how it is. I believe I'll just go back to sin because the devil's fighting me.
Really? So you're going to join arms with him? You're going to go back to the losing side? Look at your neighbor and say, if the devil's fighting against you, if he's bothering you, that's because you ain't on his team no more. What did you expect? The devil to come and sit down and have a picnic with you? The picnic basket. Hallelujah. What'd you think? He's going to come down and have a party with you, congratulate you, come and shake your hand, throw a party, you're leaving us. We're behind you, we support you. want somebody. No, he wants to kill you. He wants to destroy you. The devil don't fight anything that ain't a threat to him. But he wants you to get so far away from the cross. He wants you to get so far away, come on somebody, from seeing what Jesus did for you, amen, on that cross, that he can get your mind so weary, so filled with faint, that that's what you do is you faint. God said in Judges chapter 8 and verses 4, the Bible said that Gideon and his reduced army only had 300. Their enemies were thousands against them. And the Bible says that they were faint yet pursuing. Somebody say, faint yet pursuing. They were tired, but they kept making tracks. Come on, somebody. Because Gideon was like, where is there else to go? That's what Peter said in John 6 and 63 when Jesus said, will you, the rest of you go away? Because all those at that time, 70-something, they all walked away from Jesus, turned their back on him. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Jesus looked at his 12 and said, are y'all going to also go away? Peter said, Lord, to whom shall we go? For thou hast the words of everlasting life. Where else there to go? Who else is there to run to? Hallelujah. Through the king, escape away. I'm not dumping you. Hallelujah. Where you go, Jesus, I'll go. Praise God. I don't know nowhere else to go. I don't know nobody else to follow. Who shall we go? And Gideon said, we're faint. We feel like quitting. We feel like stopping. But it said, yet they pursued. Somebody shout, they were tired, but they kept on making tracks. They did not stop. They did not quit. Look at your neighbor, say they may have slowed down, but they didn't stop. Say it with me, they may have slowed down, but they didn't stop. Listen, I want to preach to you.